v1 plus v2. V1 plus V2 means first we need to add 10.2 plus 6.4. How much it would be? 16.6 plus or minus. Errors, absolute errors would be added here. 0.02 plus 0.01. Then answer would be 0.03. So V1 plus V2 is equals to 16.6 plus or minus 0.03. Good. Now try the difference V1 minus V2. How much answer you got, you please say? V1 minus V2.
3.8.
Plus or minus?
Minus.
No error. Now I'm asking about what would be the error.
Okay, sir.
Answer is correct. 3.8 is correct. So when we are making difference, errors would be added. Okay, as we have done V1 minus V2, 3.8 is correct. Plus or minus, we have to put 0.03. Got it now? So what is the answer we got? V1 plus V2? It is 16.6 plus or minus 0.03. V1 minus V2 is equals to 3.8 plus or minus 0.03. When two values are added, their magnitudes will be subtracted or added depends upon the situation. But errors will be added always, whether it is sum or difference. Now we will see this question clearly. Here we are coming across division. So please note it down, this question. No need to write everything in detail. Write mass value. My m plus or minus m is equals to 12.4 plus or minus 0.1. Next, volume is given. Sorry, density is given. Density is equals to 4.6 plus or minus 0.2 kg per meter cube. And we all know that formula of density. Density is equals to mass by volume. But we want volume, so volume is equals to mass by density. So, as in divisions and in multiplications, the absolute errors will not get multiplied, divided, but the relative errors or fractional errors will be added. When two values are multiplied or divided, their fractional errors or relative errors will be added. So, please note it down as it is. So relative error of mass is delta m by m. It is 0.1 by 12.4 plus relative error of density, delta rho by rho, 0.2 by 4.6. Then we will get relative error of volume. If we multiply with the volume value, then we will get absolute error of the volume, that is 0.14. So like this, we have discussed about the multiplication and division of the errors. This also we have discussed, significant figures. Then once again, you please write regarding the significant figures. First point, all non-zero digits are significant. All non-zero digits are significant. Yes, wherever the numbers are there, we can count it as. So here the problem is with the zero only. Now second point. Trapped zeros are significant. Write the second point. Trapped zeros are significant. What is this trapped zero means? The zeros in between any two non-zero digits. 108, 104. If we see that one, zero is between two non-zero digits. Such type of zeros. The trapped zeros are significant. Next, third point. Leading zeros are non-significant. Let how many zeros are there? Leading zeros are non-significant. Write the third point. Leading zeros are non-significant. And last point, trailing zeros means the zeros comes after the number. Trailing zeros are significant if decimal is there. So keep these four points in your mind. Try to answer the first question. Now, please see that how many significant figures are there in this particular number 0.0724. 7284 are significant. And these zeros are leading zeros. So not significant. Totally, how many significant figures are there?
Four,
good. As they asked, the first question is four. No need to change the number. But the same number, they asked her to write in three significant figures. So we need to omit one. The last one is four. Okay? You can omit. Why? Because as it is less than five. Now you can check her. 0.728 consists of only three significant bits. Now, if we want to write the same number in two significant figures, before omitting 8, we need to add 1 to the previous digit. Can you guess why? The last digit, if it is more than 5, we need to add 1. Nana, can you say how many significant figures are there in second question?
231.45.
Five significant figures are there. If we want to write the same number into four significant figures, we need to check this last one. If it is more than five, we need to add 1 to the previous digit. If it is less than five, we can leave it. If it is 5, depends upon the previous digit, we need to work on it. If the previous digit is even, leave. If the previous digit is odd, add 1. Actually, here the answer is 231.4. If the digit which we want to omit, if it is 5, then problem comes. Then two options are there. If the preceding digit is even, leave. Odd, add 1 to it. Okay. Now we need to write this 231.45 into 3 significant. So as 231.4, you can omit 4. It's not 5, 4. Now you want to write 2 significant figures. Generally, we feel that if we omit 1, the number would become 23. No, actually, it should be rounded off. Number should be nearer to it. So instead of leaving that, we are keeping 0 in that number. Now it is having 2 significants only. But we did not omit. If it is after the decimal, we can omit. If no decimal is there, in that place we need to put 0. I hope so that children, you have got little idea. If we do some more problems, that will make us good in that one. Significant figures and rounding off. Nana, please write this formula. A is equals to square root of PQ by R square as a cube. Most frequent appeared question in the NEET examination. And the percentage of errors as given for P, Q, R, S, and R, 1%, 3%, 0.5%, and 0.33%. Now, how do we have to calculate the maximum percentage error? So, please note down, whenever this type of expression is there with the powers, the percentages errors will be multiplied with that number and all errors will get added. So here square root of PQ is there. What is the power of P here? What is the power of P? As root is there, half. What is the power of Q? Half. So how you have to write? Half within brackets 1. Please note it down, Nana. Half within brackets 1 plus half within brackets 3. Even though powers are in the denominator, error would be added. And that whatever the power is there, that power multiplies the percentage of error. So here power of R is 2. So plus you have to write 2 within brackets 0.5. Plus, can you guess the last one? 3 into 0.33. So what is the maximum percentage of error? Half into 1% plus half into 3% plus 2 into 0.5% plus 3 into 0.33. So it is 4%. I'm getting the answer. What about you? Did you get the same? I hope so that you also got the same. So till here we discussed in the previous class. So now we are going to enter into the dimensions. Nana, do you remember the fundamental quantities? Anyone can answer, please. Fundamental quantities.
Sir, length, mass, time.
Very good. What are derived quantities? Any physical quantity which is expressed. Yes, Nana, continue.
Physical quantity.
Sir, like velocity, acceleration.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Those two are examples. Nana, another one is saying, no, please say. what are the derived quantity means? All derived quantities we can express in the terms of fundamental quantities. Previously, we are having only three, length, mass, and time. Now, in SI system, totally how many we are having? 3 plus 7.
Yes.
Plus 2 supplementary. How to remember the extra 4 means? I said that word tail, late, or etla. Anything. I generally remember by using the word late. L-A-T-E. L stands for luminous intensity. A stands for amount of substance. T stands for temperature. And E stands for electric current, ampere. Okay. For length, mass, and time, we are going to use the L, M, T. But for remaining, we are going to use their units to represent the dimensions. So please note down the dimensions. What is the dimensions means? Dimensions of a physical quantity are the powers to which the fundamental quantities must be raised to represent the given physical quantity. So here dimensions means the numbers. So when we do the calculation, we will understand it. What is the dimensional formula? Please note out this dimension formula also. It is an expression showing the powers to which the fundamental quantities are to be raised to represent, not TOO,